Central Florida hit with a wave of severe weather last night, including a tornado. The National Weather Service has now confirmed that the twister touched down in Brevard County.
Now, West 2's Greg Fox also surveyed the damage and talked with residents who are weathering the aftermath.
We're inside a mobile home park in Brevard County. This is O'Galley Estates. You can see this is just one of the trees that really took a beating from that tornado that swept through Sunday evening and fell on parts of this house.
It was pretty scary. I went and grabbed my son and threw him underneath me.
Trina Colley says once the wind whipped up and knocked the tree onto her home, her husband quickly cut it down before it crushed the roof.
Have any kind of concern that your home might not hold up in that storm?
A little bit, but we prayed and we figured it'd be all right.
This vacant home seemed to take the hardest hit. A roof peeled back like a soup can lid, and siding that sheared away allowed water to pour inside. It may not be able to be salvaged. Splintered trunks and branches littered this neighborhood from the twister that the National Weather Service estimated cut a 2.4-mile path 200 yards wide.
It sounded just like everybody says, freight train coming. We could hear some rumbling. We thought it was thunder. I poked my head outside. Big gust of wind came up. That was it.
Back inside for you.
Yep.
Robert Gillette's family feels lucky. No damage, no leaks. But their neighbors were not so lucky.
Yeah, right here.
Rick Strausberger will have to replace some or all of the floor of his home after hard driving rain poured through the seams in his roof and walls.
Well, I was hiding in the bathroom in the bathtub. That's how scared I was, and I usually don't get that scared. So
really howling out there.
It was howling.
Again, fortunately, this home was unoccupied when the storm rolled through. But for other people in this neighborhood who have some damage, like, for example, a lot of siding was ripped down, they're going to be making repairs for the next few weeks. In Brevard County, Greg Fox, West 2 News.